The story is, I mean, there's not much to the story. I didn't have any ill will toward Rick DiPietro. It was, we were up 3-0 with 16 or under 16 seconds left to play. And he kind of clips Cook. He kind of clips Cookie, and Cookie goes flying. Now, at the time, I don't know. Cookie could sell anything, right? Like, I don't know if he's bullshitting or not. But actually, after looking at it, he really did hit him pretty good. And so I was like, man, there's only 15 seconds. We're up 3-0. Who gives a shit? Let's go. And going down there, I was first off thinking, how am I going to get around the ref? And then second off thinking, all right, he's a lefty. He catches silly side. So he's a silly sider. So now I'm going to have to grab him with my right. And then just, you know, it's just one of those, you know, you just grab, and I'm a lot lankier than he is. He's a little bit smaller. So I got, my fist got to his face first. And unfortunate that, you know, like as much as I'd like to say, oh my God, it's so cool that I, you know, broke somebody's face, you know, or whatever, but he's an American guy. And it wasn't like I was sitting there to reporters being like, I told him he shouldn't mess with me or something. I wasn't doing that. You know, I was trying to be as humble about it as I could. And, you know, and I think that that's maybe where hockey guys kind of, we don't get ourselves pushed into the mainstream as much because we're more humble than the other major professional sports. Whereas if I was just like, yeah, I told that son of a bitch, he ever tries that shit again, I'm like, no, that would have been awesome if I would have, but no, that's not how it happened at all.